friends, welcome to another episode of A Single Girl's Gotta Eat, the cooking show. You guys, today's recipe, first of all, it smells so good already. We haven't even made it, but it's so easy and it's so few ingredients. It's gonna be awesome. But I wanted to tell you, I am taking this recipe today from one of my very favorite chefs. Call her a chef. She's a chef. Cookbook authors, Julie Bauer. She is PaleyOMG on social media. On her website is PaleyOMG. She's awesome. She's a Denver girl and just is a tremendous cook. And so I take a lot of my recipes from her because she is just the best. So we are making slow cooker tomatillo chicken. And it's in this recipe book of hers, the Paleo Kitchen. She's got a couple. So, you guys, super, super simple. Slow cooker, chicken, tomatillos, onion, jalapeno, chicken broth, some spices. That's it. Okay. So let's get going. We are going to cook this on low for 6 to 8 hours. We're cooking it on low for 8 hours. Okay. Let me tell you what we're going to do, and then I will layer in the ingredients for you. Cook it on low for 8 hours. When the cooking time is up, you're going to pull the chicken out, shred it. Then you're going to take what's left, the sauce, throw it in a blender, like a good blender, and then blitz it into a sauce. You can do that, or you can use an immersion blender. That was the other thing I was going to say. So that's what we're going to do. I'll repeat it again at the end just as a reminder, but let's layer this in. You guys, this is so easy. Okay, first thing you're going to do is take one red onion and slice it. Okay, just put it into slices. You're just going to layer them in the bottom of the crock pot. Okay, we're going to put all of those in. Easy peasy. You are going to use 2 pounds of chicken breast. Okay, so we always get the chicken from Costco, which is just ginormous chicken. So again, chicken is a great thing. Meat is a great thing to buy in bulk if you've got the space to freeze it, and if you've got the people who can eat it with you. So anyways, with the Costco chicken, like, these things are huge, and so I feel like 2 pounds is like 2 chicken breasts. So that is what I'm putting in today. Just gonna layer that in the bottom, not in the bottom. I have a love-hate relationship with tongs because sometimes they work super well and other times they just get caught and they're just dumping it. That will work. So if you have tongs that work well for you, use them. If you do not, just dump it in from the plate. Okay, after that, you guys, we are going to put in 1.5 pounds of tomatillos. Okay, so if you have not used tomatillos before, they're just like little green tomatoes, but they come inside of a husk. They're really kind of just fun. So they come inside of a husk, peel off the husk, wash them because they're a little sticky, and then half them or quarter them. I quartered the big ones and then just half the small ones. So 1.5 pounds of those, put those in. 1 jalapeno. I de-seeded mine just because Mama Mare, since we're back in Mama Mare's kitchen, Mama Mare doesn't like the spice as much as I do. So I de-seeded this one. As far as like food ingredients, that is it. The next thing we're going to do is add in, oh, I forgot one other thing. Hold that thought. We cannot proceed without the garlic. You know what I'm saying? But we are going to put in 1.5 cups of chicken broth. Okay. We do that really quick. Wish I had this pre-measured for you, but I didn't. Oh my gosh, this is going to be so good. These flavors would be good for, I mean, it's going to be awesome in this chicken recipe, but it's going to, like, you could do the tomatillos with like some cayenne or some crushed red pepper. If you like, you know, if you want to up the spice or a little bit, you could do it with beef. You could do it with pork. I mean, it'd be so good with so many different types of protein. garlic, we are going to do, it calls for 4 cloves. Obviously cloves and the minced garlic are different. I'm just gonna put in a couple big heaping teaspoonfuls because I love garlic. So I know you can have too much garlic, but you know, I tend to probably push the limit of the garlic because I love it so much. Then you're gonna add like 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper. I'm just gonna do this on top here. And 1 teaspoon of salt, okay? And then, of course, you're going to season to taste, you know, as you're going through, or just, you know, whenever you have cooked your meal and you're eating it. Now, here's the deal. You guys, that's it. That is it. Isn't that so awesome? I mean, it's like the easiest recipe in the whole entire world. So here's the deal with this. You can eat this plain. Like, it's going to be a hearty meal. So, again, once you, again, low 8 hours. Pull the chicken out, shred it, and then blend. I mean, make sure your blender can do hot liquids. That's just the key there. So either use an immersion blender or make sure your blender can do hot liquids. And blitz the sauce to make it just like this beautiful tomatillo sauce. You could probably eat it by itself. You could eat it over rice. You could eat it over pasta. You could eat it you know, with a salad, I mean, whatever, like this is going to be a good hearty meal. So that is today's dinner, tomatillo chicken from Julie Bowers, the Paleo Kitchen. She's Paleo OMG. She's the bomb. So go follow her. I really, really like her. That's it for today. Thanks for watching another episode of A Single Girl's Gotta Eat, the cooking show. And just remember, A Single Girl's Gotta Eat is just a single girl's guide to doing singleness well. So much love, friends.